Don't think about a big pink elephant with big ears and purple spots wearing shades. What? I told you not to think about it. Hey there everyone, I am Apurva and welcome back to my channel once again. Today I'm here to share the deep little secrets of how our dominant thoughts create our lives. This is going to be a hell of a ride, so if you guys are ready, make sure you're subscribed and let's dive in. Now first of all, let me ask you one question. How often have you found yourself precisely in the situation that you said you didn't want? Pretty much all the time. The principle here is, you think about something and you move towards it. Even if you think about something you don't want, you still move towards it. Because our mind has the capability only to move towards things and never away from them. Remember how I asked you not to think about that elephant, but still what you did? You thought of exact same elephant that I asked you not to imagine. This is because your mind works on pictures, so when you say to yourself, I don't want to forget that book, your mind creates an image of you forgetting that book, and then you end up forgetting it in actual. But on the other hand, when you say to yourself that I want to remember that book, your mind creates an image of you remembering that book, and then you end up having it with you and not forgetting about it. You can also relate to other such situations where you don't want to be in certain things and you end up being in that particular situation. So this is what happens, and this is where positive thinking comes into play, because our mind creates only positive images if we think positive, and then it certainly ends up into creating positive situations in real. But have you wondered how does it all happen? Here, the secret little mystery plays the bigger role, and it is called our subconscious mind. Whatever happens around you, it happens because it is deep-rooted into your subconscious mind. In short, it means that whatever your subconscious mind believes, it is the only things that you get. Consider your mind to be like an iceberg where you are only aware of the outer, that is the conscious part, and you are not at all aware of the bigger and the deeper and the hidden part, that is the subconscious mind. Your mind is like an iceberg in that while you are more aware of your outer or conscious mind, the part with the greater impact is the hidden part. All of your conscious thoughts contribute to your subconscious mind. Your bodily functions, your attitude, your all learned skills are keyed into your subconscious mind, which is why you do some things without even thinking. Claude Bristol in his book The Magic of Believing stated, just as the conscious mind is the source of thought, so the subconscious is the source of power. Your subconscious mind contains your programs of walking, talking, healing your body, thinking about problems, and much, much more. And it's only the subconscious programs that are responsible for your success or failures. If you consistently walk, talk, or think success, you will develop a subconscious expectancy of success. Similarly, if you keep thinking about sickness, your subconscious mind will accept sickness pattern and you will end up being sick every other day. You create programs in your subconscious by your thoughts, so watch what you think. Implant your goals into your subconscious mind as if they have already been achieved. See those results already achieved, and your subconscious mind will all set up to make that happen in real. This principle is proven to work consistently, so if it gets results, use it. Use more of imagination to get the life that you've always imagined. I hope you found this helpful and liked it, and if you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and comment down below and subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends, spread happy positive vibes. I'll see you next time. Bye.